Now the Kenya Medical Supplies Authority is inching closer to appointing a substantive procurement director after sending its acting procurement director, Gilbert Mamati, on suspension. KEMSA chairperson Irungu Nyakera has further revealed that 23 staff members in the procurement department have been reshuffled after an internal audit revealed irregularities.
As part of ongoing reforms aimed at enhancing its performance and gaining public trust, Kenya Medical Supplies Authority Board has revealed its decision to suspend its acting director, Gilbert Mamati. Chairperson Irungu Nyakera says the director will be required to independently respond to audit queries.
The tender is one that then pointed at a few irregularities. Yeah, that like the ones you are saying, a company that had not passed even the opening stage because they did not paginate getting an award.
Addressing the press on Wednesday, Nyakera also confirmed that counties owe KEMSA a total of 6 billion shillings after supplying drugs. Nairobi, Homa Bay, Kakamega, and Taita Taveta counties account for 464 million shillings of the total debt owed.
We owe 3 billion, and counties owe us 3.1, but in total we owe 6 billion. So once we get half our money, we're able to pay all our debts.
KEMSA has also announced plans to reduce distribution and transportation costs from 1 billion to 600 million shillings. Meanwhile, KEMSA CEO Dr. Andrew Mulwa says it has sorted out the shortage in supply of asthma drugs, including the Ventolin inhaler experienced in the country last month.
We have been able to resolve that. We did an emergency procurement and got another supplier sourcing drugs from another manufacturer globally. And the supplier who we had initially given was also able to supply initial supplies, which have stabilized the availability of TB drugs.
For Prime Edition, I'm Joseph Wahungu.